So, in today's assignment, I would like you to learn about KKT by doing this homework problem. In the first part, by now you know what a Randles circuit is, right? So, first part, I want you to synthesize the spectrum for a Randles circuit with 10 ohm of solution resistance, 20 microfarad of double layer capacitance, and 100 ohms for charge transfer resistance. I would like you to synthesize frequencies in the range of 1 millihertz to 1 megahertz, and although I do not say it explicitly here, you have to do it in log scale, and you probably want to do it in the frequency spaced at 7 frequencies per decade or maybe 10 frequencies per decade. The next part is a little more involved. Okay. I would like you to write a program to do KKT integration. KKT integration goes from 0 to infinity. Of course, you go from low frequency of 1 millihertz to 1 megahertz, that is good enough. Okay. But you have to write the program, you have to write the equation, and then write the program to handle that integration. You can use a simple integration like trapezoidal integration or Simpson rule, it is all right. I just want you to try this. And in the KKT equations, you will have a case where x minus omega will come in the denominator. So, when you use a particular omega, I want you to think about how to handle it. It is not that difficult, but I would like you to think about it and then perform this integration. So, generate the spectrum which will have data of frequency, real and imaginary part, and then using your program, use the frequency and real part and transform and get the transformed part for the imaginary and compare with the imaginary that you got from the original simulation. We will call the first set as original simulation, transform data we will say KK transform data. Similarly, using the frequency and imaginary data, integrate this, use this integral equations and then predict the value of real impedance and then compare with this original data. In the next part, I would like you to just select some publication, journal publication, good quality journal. Look at the impedance spectrum. If you have Bode plots, that is good. You should learn how to digitize data. Okay, there are free software available to help you do this. This will be useful not just in this course, in general. So, you should do this. Digitize the data. So, you have magnitude versus frequency and phase versus frequency, or real versus frequency and imaginary versus frequency. Then I would like you to subject this to KKT. You can use your own program or you can use any of the freely available program or a commercial software, it is fine. You cannot use complex plane plot data and digitize it and get this, because you will need frequency data as an input to the KKT program. Now, the third part, what I want to do is this. Although you have generated data from 1 millihertz to 1 megahertz, let us just pretend that the data is available only from 10 hertz to 100 kilohertz. Okay. Now, you can use different methods of applying KKT. In one method, I want you to use integration, actual integration equations. Okay. It could be something that is written by you, it could be something that is available in a commercial program, it does not matter, but I would like you to try a method where equations are used and actual integration is performed. Second, I would like you to try the software Linear KKT that is available for free. Now, when I use a truncated set of data, there is going to be difference based on whether the KKT evaluation is performed by integrating that equations or whether it is performed by using measurement model approach or linear KKT. So, what is the difference? I would like you to actually try and see. Then, the one that is taken from commercial sources, I am sorry, the one that is taken from journal publication. If you use linear KKT versus if you use equations and integration of those equations, do you see any difference? Okay. So, this is also helpful for you to learn what is a good way to validate the data. Third part, maybe I was expecting a little more than what I should from most of you, but it is all right. So, generate a data, and then I wanted you to write the KKT code and explain how you will handle the case where x equal to omega, because you have a case where you have an integral with x minus omega in the denominator. 0 to infinity of course goes from low frequency to high frequency. So, this you can call it as integrand. There are many ways of handling it. One, if you know the function, you can use L'Hopital rule and get these results. But we do not know the function, we just say that, of course, we do know the function because we are generating it here using a particular circuit, but generally you will get impedance data, that is all. If you know the function, you probably do not need to bother about this. We do not know the function, we get impedance data, but given each data, you can calculate the integrand at those values. So, if you calculate the integrand as a function of x, it will go like this. At one point, you are going to have x equal to omega, you cannot calculate it, but you can use interpolation, that is the crudest or simplest way. Okay. Next, you can fit it to a curve and then use interpolation, meaning linear interpolation. Fit it to a curve, then artificially say that this can be represented by a quadratic function, and then I will use L'Hopital rule to fit it to a curve, where numerator part is fitted to a curve, denominator is taken, and then you can do this. Because integral can smoothen out some of the fluctuations, even the simplest method will give you a reasonable result. At the end points, you will have to use extrapolation. So, when you say x equal to low frequency or high frequency, you will have to use extrapolation. Anything else, you will be able to use interpolation, and in all cases, it will work reasonably well. If you are not able to handle, that is okay, but I would have liked you to try actual integration. I think only two of you tried. Select a journal data and subject it to KKT just for you to have an idea of how to handle when you get your own data. If you reduce the frequency range artificially, saying that we have not taken data at the full range or it is noisy at the low frequency, therefore we had to neglect it, then linear KKT will give us correct information on whether the data is KKT compliant or not. When you use actual integration, if the low frequency is not low enough, we are not really giving the correct input, therefore we will not get the correct result. In this case, we have taken a data which is actually KKT compliant, but we won't know it because we are not using the integration properly, we are not giving the limits properly, we are not approximating the 0 and infinity limits correctly. Linear KKT will still handle this case or any other equivalent approach of fitting. And if you vary the time constant, there will be some variation in the residuals. That is all I wanted you to